to the MVAC Lab. Today, we're going to turn our attention to end scrapers, chipped stone tools used for scraping objects such as animal hides. Native people made them in all archaeological time periods, but we most often find these implements on late pre-contact Oneota sites in the Lacrosse region, and in larger form from Paleo-Indian contexts dating thousands of years earlier. They're much rarer at archaic and woodland sites.
People manufactured end scrapers from a number of lithic raw materials, mainly higher quality cherts. These teardrop or thumbnail-shaped tools were made by working one side of a flake to create a beveled scraping edge at one end, thus the term end scraper. Sharp, non-working edges were roughened, so the scraper could be handled and hafted without cutting through the binding. The opposite surface was left unworked.
End scrapers, at least in the driftless area, were mostly used to dress dry hides, which can then be made into clothing or used for other purposes. The working edge, like the one on this replica end scraper, had to be sharp enough to remove unwanted material from the hide without cutting it.
Hide working produces wear patterns we can see on the scraping edge, including smoothing, rounding and polish, seen here on the left side of the scraper, and pitting, visible on the right. Smoothing or rounding on the end opposite the working edge indicates that a scraper was hafted to a wood or antler handle, similar to these modern experimental examples and this artist's reconstruction. Scrapers also could have been handheld. With continued use, the edge angle of an end scraper would get steeper, and the user would retouch or resharpen the dulled and ineffective edge of the tool, causing the scraper to get shorter and the edge to get much steeper over time. UW Lacrosse student Joelle McCarthy's senior thesis study found a working edge angle of around 45 degrees to be ideal for hide processing, with an upper limit of effectiveness of 60 degrees. We often recover very small end scrapers with steep edge angles from Oneota sites in our region. This suggests people tended to retouch end scrapers until they were no longer effective before discarding them.
And now, these expended tools help us to hone our understanding of lithics and life long ago. Thanks for watching.